I gotta lay this down for the universe. I was chilling with my boy. We're at the golf course. We just got off working, and we're chilling. We're sipping a beer, kicking it. And he's like, "Yo, what's the difference, man? Like, what's the difference, like, of me being here? There's 6 billion people on this earth. I'm gonna come. I'm gonna lay my life. I'm gonna die. The earth's been here before me. It's gonna be long after. What is my difference?" At the time, I said something that was like, you know, you gotta start somewhere, you gotta do the right thing, blah, 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 blah. But I didn't really have a great answer for him. And then it was at that night when I went home that I realized a lot of times we argued, is everything completely random? Is everything happening for a reason? And I realized that night, I was like, yo, you're both fucking right. Because God or whoever created this universe has knowledge that you can't comprehend. So if you're living your life like everything's a coincidence, you know, I don't believe in that shit, everything is science, you know, I need to see proof, you know, everything's just completely random, your whole experience on this planet, your whole trip will be completely random. If you believe everything's happened for a reason, I swear to fucking God, everything in your life will happen for a reason. And you can't put that past me because I'm a living testament to that theory. No one can hold this conversation with me because my life is so fucking crazy. It's because, I'll start naming some shit. I was adopted. My girlfriend, the only woman I ever loved on this planet, my ex-girlfriend, had an abortion on my birthday. Wasn't supposed to happen on my birthday, wasn't scheduled for it. Some shit got fucked up when we went, it wound up happening on that day. I don't want to get into specifics with that, but you know what I'm saying? And everything. And then we were out in California, man. I was just thinking, like, this shit was getting to me, and I was like, yo, I gotta hit the Bible, man. I gotta reopen the Bible, yo. And so I took the Bible with me on the trip knowingly, and then we're chilling, I'm reading the Bible. I open to the book of Matthew, I'm flipping through the book of Matthew, I'm reading it, I'm soaking it up, I'm like, yes, this is good. I pick up my head, I look at the television screen, Bernie fucking Mac, yo. Bernie fucking Mac looks into the television screen, God rest his soul. At the end of his TV shows, as he always does, he looks in the screen and quotes the book of Matthew. I'm like, alright. Like, at this point, like, I've had so much shit in my life happen that it's just like, me and God are tight, yo. Me and God were like, alright, God, I see you, I see you. So, like, it's just it got to that point. This shit happened to me fucking today. Someone that I gave so much of my fucking life to, had done so much for it. I do, like, I get a good feeling out of doing things for people. I do a lot of good things for people. But some days this shit will fuck with you, because I did so much for this person. I was like, yo, listen, I need you to do this one thing for me. And they didn't do it. And I was tight. Like, yo, you don't understand. This is deeper than you. I gave so much to you, number one. But I gave so much to everyone. I did right by so many people. I need this. It's about fucking time that I fucking need this shit. And it just couldn't physically happen. So I'm sitting at home like, fuck. The Jets game's on, like, it's tied up with the Patriots in overtime. I didn't even give a fuck. I'm like, yo, fuck. You know, my whole thought process is like, yo, I've given so much, I need to get in return. And so I pick up my sister. We're going out to get a slice of pizza and shit. And I'm thinking about it. It's on my mind. I'm thinking about it. And so I order. Right after I order, I start thinking about it again. And out of the fucking, there was like really no one in the pizzeria this time. This dude on the phone is talking on the phone. It's like, yeah, but you know, you gotta keep giving. Cause the more you're giving, the more you're gonna get. I'm like, yo, God, stop fucking with me. Stop fucking with me. But I love when he fucks with me. That's why I am who I am. Like, I say this to people, yo, like, I have a creative mind because of my life. Whoever is doing my life, since it's like Truman Show shit, but whoever is doing my life is more creative than any story I could ever write. So that's why all I can do is rap my life, because I know that shit's gonna be hard. But that's why, like, when I go, this is why I'm doing this shit with the cheesy music in the background, because when I go out to the bar, or I see someone, and I catch them in that element, and I'm in that element, it's the right time, and I break shit down to them, they're like, I was telling this girl, like, yo, go for it, like, you need to do this shit. She was like, this girl I grew up with, she's like, yeah, I don't know. I was like, yo, look me in the fucking eye, like, if you're gonna do this shit, you better do this shit. And shout to her, she did it, yo. Shout to Caroline. I remember she went on Facebook the next day, it was like, thank you, you know, like, so that's why we're here, yo. That's why we're here. That's the golf course answer. You know, I think we as people, we need social media likes on our actions, because we need to see something in return. That's why I needed to see something earlier. Like, I needed to see the universe get back to me. We need to see something in return. So it's like, if I do that, that should be like fucking boom, like 1,000 likes on some like gangsta god shit. But you know, that's why, like, if I put up like a picture of like me finally like opening up a door at Atlantic Records and shit, man, people liked it, cause they know, like, I've been doing this shit forever. So that's why I fuck with everyone that liked that picture. But at the same time, like, you just liking this shit cause, you know, you just see Atlantic on it. But the other people that really know my grind is liking it cause they're like, yo, about fucking time. But some of the mirror said to me, it was like, I don't know, 3 or 4 years back, he's like, yo, man, like, you know, if I don't have a good day or something, like, I get caught up doing some shit, and I'm at, like, everything I do, I gotta do something to further from where I am today to get closer to where I need to be tomorrow. So at the end of the night, if I get caught up doing some shit, I'm gonna send some emails out, I'm reaching out and send some joints out, boom, 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 I'm doing this, you know what I'm saying? Even some little bullshit. And that shit hit me because I was like, yo, listen, everything that we have come across has been fucking random. The people that put me in contact with the dude that got me in Atlantic was fucking random, a random reach out. The person that had me on the radio, I could work my fucking ass off all my life trying to perfect my craft, entering contests, doing showcases. Nothing ever came of that shit. But the one time we sent out a random fucking email to, like, my boy's girlfriend's friend's boyfriend, and then the fucking DJ from 92.3 hit me back, who's real as shit. Shout out to Tic Tac, you a real motherfucker, you don't understand this. And, hit me back, put me on the radio and shit, had me buzzing for a little bit. But it's almost as if God is seeing your energy and making up for the other shit that didn't happen. You know? Like, no, you didn't get the contest, you didn't get the hit record you thought you had to just go viral, but because of that hard work, I'm gonna make this random fucking email you just sent blow your shit up or get you further. And it's like, a lot of times when you're like, damn, yo, like, you just get impatient, especially chasing some shit that you shouldn't be chasing, according to my mother and shit. You're gonna get impatient as fuck. Like, you just feel stuck some days. But it's gotten so far as, like, if I stop, I can't even stop. I can't even stop. I was thinking about this the other day. I was like, because I can't stop. Because I had people, I had my other boy I've known all my life since kindergarten crying to me in the car, telling me, like, yo, dog, like, you're special. And I was like, nah, man, like, you know what I'm saying? You know, you do you, we're all good people. He's like, nah, cut the bullshit, dude. Like, you're special. He's like, all you do is just positive shit. Like, you're special. And, like, God's put you through a lot of shit, more than anyone around here, and you're special. And I was like, and it hit me, and I was like, damn, like, I can't stop. Like, if I stop, that'd fuck other people up. It's deeper than me. So that's why I make music, and this is why I do what I do.
Because all we've seen is tough luck, and we like smoke when it's puffed up. We rising. I said, yeah, bitch, we rising. I fucking work my ass off. Why is this surprising?